Welcome to unit 5.3. The last unit was again pretty long, sorry, but I can promise this unit will be shorter. We will have a look at benzene. The crystal structure is shown here in space-filling representation, and we will scratch a topic called polymorphism, the fact that one and the same compound can realize different crystal structures. Benzene is a molecule with a hexagonal shape, belonging to the so-called aromatic hydrocarbon compounds, with the formula unit C6H6. It is a very important industrial compound from which several other important chemicals are derived in high production volumes. Unfortunately, it is also a very harmful substance. It can cause cancer and other severe illnesses. But nonetheless, benzene builds an interesting crystal structure, and we are safe to look at it on a screen. At room temperature, it is a colorless liquid, but below 5.5 degrees, it crystallizes, namely in the space group PBCA, with these lattice parameters. So we should be able to derive the crystal class without any effort. This is, of course, MMM. And it belongs to the orthorhombic crystal system. Okay, let's have a look now at its crystal structure, and again with our program Mercury. Voila! First, only as a short recapitulation, although it might look to some of you like an example of a face-centered cell, it is of course not, because for this, the orientation of the benzene molecules would have to be the same at all positions, and here they differ. Only the molecules at the corners have the same orientation, so it's a primitive lattice. The second thing I would like to illustrate to you is a parallel to one geometrical law we know already by heart. Two perpendicular mirror planes automatically generate a twofold axis of rotation at their point of intersection, or at their line of intersection. Now, here in benzene, we do not have three simple mirror planes, but three glide planes. Let's have a look. Glide planes parallel to the AC plane, the BC plane, and along the AB plane as well. Each two of them are perpendicular to each other. So guess, what kind of symmetry element will be probably automatically generated by two perpendicular glide planes? Yes, the respective rotation axis with an additional translational component, and this is a screw axis. What kind? Well, the translation component of glide planes A, B or C are all 1/2, so it's a 2-1 screw axis. And we can have a look. Display. Symmetry elements, screw axes. Yes, here they are, running all along the lines of intersections of these glide planes. Okay, that should it be for now concerning this particular crystal structure, but additionally I would like to take the example of benzene to bring another feature of crystal structures to your attention. This is polymorphism. Polymorphism describes the phenomenon that some compounds can crystallize in different crystal structures. This is often dependent on the outer conditions, such as pressure, temperature, and so on, under which the crystallization occurs. Note that polymorphism has nothing to do with the different outer shapes, the morphology which we discussed in chapter 2. Benzene crystallizes not only in the space group PBCA, which we have just seen, but under higher pressure, the crystal will undergo a phase transition towards a structure with the space group P21 over C. And there are at least four more other known polymorphs. Maybe the fact that the structure will change if we exert a certain pressure on it is not that surprising. But what I find extremely interesting is the following fact. Although all physical or physicochemical laws responsible for realizing a certain crystal structure are known, it is only possible to predict a crystal structure in a very limited number of cases. The limitation of predictions despite good knowledge of the underlying laws behind, is also true for other scientific disciplines. For instance, meteorology. You can find this very interesting article in which these difficulties of predicting crystal structures are outlined for the case of benzene in the reference section. That was it.